Hi everyone, you're watching Stories That Matter. This is Bushra Sadkhir. Today I'll be talking about an issue that is happening in the city of Pune from the state of Maharashtra on behalf of MIT students. MIT World Peace University, Pune, had promised its engineering students of 2017 Golden Scholar Batch a study tour of 4 to 6 weeks in top universities of the United States of America and Europe. Fees for the international study tour, that is called IST, was to be collected from students in 4 installments of ₹50,000 each, which covered travel and stay in the European countries for more than 1 month. The IST was scheduled to happen in July 2020. Now, almost all parents had deposited ₹50,000 every year towards IST as an advance. However, due to the COVID pandemic situation, the IST cannot be conducted, as we all know, in the year 2020 and even till today, that is in the year 2021. Because travel and visa restrictions are there in many countries, there is a lot of travel ban that is happening in the European countries. Now, even after the delay of IST and considering the economic and social disruption that has been caused by the COVID pandemic, all the students and the parents, they had decided to completely, you know, cooperate with the management of the college and paid the fees as per the demands for the academic year 2020-2021, and requested clarification regarding the international study tour, because since it's not going to happen, they needed some clarification as to what is going to happen with that money or if they are going to get any kind of refund. Some parents did not pay the fees, the last installment, that is of 50 or 60,000 rupees. Some have paid the complete fees. Now, there are different cases in all the students. Now, coming to the current scenario, the parents have been requesting the university to cancel the tour considering the current COVID pandemic situation. And since there is no international study tour, why should the students pay, you know, 2 lakhs if they are not going to go to that tour? Parents have been requesting through personal meetings and phone calls and emails with the college authorities for adjusting the university, like, you know, for adjusting with the university regarding the IST fees. Moreover, adding to this problem, students' results were being withheld by the university, and also they were reportedly not being allowed to appear for the final trimester exams that are scheduled in June 2021, that are going to happen now. Now, MIT University, they had proposed 2 options. One was that students will be provided with an online certification course from foreign universities, and second was that students will be taken for the international study tour within the next 2 to 3 years after graduation. And then students were asked to only choose one from these 2 options. However, students refused to do that because none of these options were worth consideration because of the following reasons. One was that the option of providing an online certificate course, it is completely illogical, because firstly, students can easily access such courses from, you know, platforms like Coursera and edX. These courses are offered in mere thousands of rupees, it's not costing 2 lakhs. So they do not want that. Moreover, you know, such courses are a choice of students. If they want to take it after they pursue their field of profession, after they do a master's, and if they feel that, you know, there are some skills that they require, according to that they can choose such, you know, online certificate courses, and they can do it whenever they want. So like, you know, they cannot be compelled to take this certificate course because a study tour has been cancelled due to the, you know, pandemic situation, a very unavoidable situation by the university. Second reason is that the point of a study tour is when the students are studying. So if the students have graduated, if they have done with their studies, then what's the point of taking them to a study tour? That too after 2-3 years. So the argument for the students and the parents against the university was that it's very uncertain where the students will be in their life at that point of time. They can, you know, they have different commitments. Some might be pursuing masters like M.Tech and M.S. Some might be preparing for government opportunities like, you know, UPSC, MPSC. Some might have jobs in, you know, big MNCs. How can they, you know, take 1 month or more than 1 month off from these commitments that they will have after, you know, 2-3 years? And how will the university gather all the students of that particular batch, that is the 2017 batch, and, you know, take them to a study tour? It's actually pointless to think about it.
I am a direct second year student, so I joined college in the second year after completing my diploma. But still, I was asked to pay 50,000 for the first year. So technically I paid 50,000 for the year that I never attended the college. Now I am attaching the fees breakage here. So as you can see that 50,000 is for international study tour fees. Now after 1 year of harassing students, the college has given us two options. The first option, that they will take us to the international study tour after 3 to 4 years, and the second option, that they will provide us with courses from universities such as MIT and Harvard, etc. Now talking about the first option, that is they will take us after 3 to 4 years, all of my friends and including myself, we are placed. Some of us are going for higher studies, that is MS, MTech and MBA, and some are preparing for examinations such as UPSC. So how we will get 1 month of time after 3-4 years to go for this international study tour? The second option they gave us was the courses that they will provide. Now these courses from Harvard, from MIT are available on Coursera for like just 3,000 to 4,000 rupees, max to max 10,000 rupees, but they are providing us these courses for rupees 2 lakh rupees. And the college will end now in July 2021. How we will complete these courses after the college? Like, it would be a burden to us that we had to complete these courses. So we, all the students and the parents, are requesting the college management to refund us the fees back or adjust the fees in the fourth year. Like, we have already paid the 1,50,000 of the 3 years, so just adjust it in the fourth year. But they are not listening to us.
Now MIT World Peace University is a very reputed institute, we all know that. They want their students to have a, you know, experiential learning, and they want a well-balanced academic framework as they promise. So they want their students to have an international exposure as well. No matter how good the intent is, unfortunately, during this crisis period, the entire world is at a halt because of, you know, COVID. And of course, due to the lockdown, now economies and businesses across the globe are suffering, and they have been severely hit by these uncertain circumstances. It is important for the university to accept this situation and listen to the pleas of the students and their parents and understand their situation as well. The alternate solutions that have been provided by the university, like the certificate programs that come under management, engineering and technology, it's not justified, because that is not enough. Paying so much of money for a study tour, it's injustice for these students. And then taking them to this tour after a few years is also not really, reasonable. It's of no use, because if the students are not studying in that university, after a few years, they might get that experience by themselves. They might go for a post-graduation abroad, so they don't need that study tour anymore. The need ends right there. So no matter how much the university claims, to give enough time and flexibility for students to, prepare for that, it's not going to be of any value. Now the simple solution to this is to cancel the IST completely and for this batch, and to refund and adjust the payments of the parents of each student. Now in the latest development, the university has reportedly agreed that if any student or their families are facing any financial hardship due to loss of job or business or other constraints, like plans for higher studies or job placements, they will review such cases, and on the basis of merit, the university will consider adjusting the due fees or execute refunds as deemed necessary on case-to-case basis. Now this is great, because the university has somewhere agreed to help the students in understanding their point of view. The university wants to somewhere refund the students, which is a good thing. The university is listening to the pleas of the students, the demands of the students and their parents, which is great. However, this is a conditional commitment that has been offered by the university. While this update, it brings some hope for the parents and the students, they still have to request the university to refund the amount of IST unconditionally, that is completely, because if they're going to see from case to case to each student, there might be some students who won't have any such constraints, but they still don't want to go to the study tour, so the university can't force them, right? That is one issue. Secondly, if the students are collectively, the parents and the students, they are collectively asking that they don't want to go to a tour at all, if it's after 1 year, 2 year, 3 years, they don't want to get the online certification course as well, and they don't have any such, you know, issues which the university has mentioned here, such as financial hardships or loss of job or anything else, then the university cannot, you know, ask the students to give a very valid reason. The valid reason for the students would be that they do not want to go to the tour because of the COVID pandemic situation. They do not wish to go to the tour. And what would they do if half of their class won't go with them? That is also one thing. So the university must issue a statement that they completely will refund that amount or adjust it completely in the fees for the remaining parents, and, you know, settle the situation with the parents and the students and close it very smoothly and very simply. So here's hoping that the university makes the right decision and it considers all the demands of the students and refunds all the amount to the parents that has been paid by them, and, you know, cancels the study tour completely in terms of the pandemic and for the sake of the students as well. Now, this story is not just about one university, it is about many universities, you know, that might be, you know, having some issues with fees and other kind of, you know, such commitments where they will be saying that, you know, they won't refund some amounts, which, like, you know, for example, transportation amounts or extra tuition amounts. Since the pandemic has hit every state, in every city, every state, every country in the world, it's a common situation. It is not about one small district, one village, one town, one city. It is about the entire world. So all the education institutions should understand the situation of parents and their financial conditions as well. We do understand that, you know, many of the institutes must have suffered as well. Many of the small schools, small universities, big universities, everyone is suffering due to the pandemic. Such kind of situations should not arise. There should be understanding, there should be some sort of mutual understanding between the two parties, whether it is the university, whether it is the students, whether it is the parents, whether it is the teaching staff, anybody. Secondly, universities need to understand that, you know, such kind of tours, educational visits cannot happen because we are not in a position to even bring students under one classroom. Third wave might come anytime soon, might hit us anytime soon. We need to be prepared, we need to be understanding, we have to listen and adjust with the demands of each other if it is having a genuine reason. So MIT World Peace University, for now, they must refund the students completely of the IST charges, and they must understand that the students are neither willing for an online certificate course nor do they want to go for a study tour after a few years. So instead of the university, you know, wasting some more time in, you know, seeing each student's case and giving them the refund based on merit, that is becoming conditional again. Only thing that the university must now do is unconditionally refund all the students of the 2017 Golden Scholar batch for the IST. Unfortunately, it is not the university's fault, it is not the students' fault, it is just fault of this bad timing due to this virus that we all are facing. So here's hoping that the university will understand, consider and make the right decision for the students, and other universities will also take a good lesson from this and not put their students in a situation such as the ones that MIT students have gone through. We do not know now what the university will do. It has only promised until now to, you know, refund on a conditional basis. Hopefully the university will do something more from this in a few days. For now, the students are a bit relieved. This notice came in on June 1st, which is very recent. Depending on what happens next, we can see what the update is, and here's to hoping that it does provide some relief to the students and the university gives them their results as well as their allows the students to sit in the next exams so that they graduate and get their degrees peacefully amid this crisis situation and move on with their careers. This testing times will end soon, inshallah, but we have to stay strong and we have to also fight for our rights wherever it is required. So that's about it for this story. I hope you find this video informative. If you do, please do share and subscribe to my channel. Do like and comment your thoughts below in the comment section. As a citizen, we can only support the students by raising a voice for them. You can share this video as much as possible so that people know about what is happening around them. For more such stories that matter to you, keep watching. See you in another episode. This is Bushra Sathkhed signing off.